Oak Lake, Manitoba, a quiet prairie town. A grim ordeal took place there that was heard the nation round. It all began on Monday, January 23rd. A motel owner in Virden town to the Mounties he sent word. He said a couple had just checked in a truck with BC plates. On a list of stolen cars he had, one license was the same. Three RCMP officers went there to check things out and asked that BC couple what this was all about. They walked on to the motel door with their revolvers drawn, when a blast from a 12-gauge shotgun came ripping through the door. When the gunfight was all over, one Mountie, he lay dead. The other two were wounded, they did not know how bad. The gunman's wife was also hit, they fled in the Mountie's car. Stopped at a farmhouse down the road for a doctor to inquire. They took the farmer hostage, drove on to Oak Lake town, pulled up in the local doctor's house, which the Mounties did surround. The woman was taken by ambulance, her wounds to be repaired. The doctor, his wife, and farmer at gunpoint were held there. The gunman asked for money, 100,000 cash, a plane for Argentina, or more lives would be lost. Then late on Wednesday evening, the doctor was released. They knew the gunman could not last much longer without sleep. At 3 a.m. on Friday, the four-day siege did end, when the man called Herbert Archer came out with upraised hands. Hostages were all unharmed and answered many prayers, but they'd never forgotten what they went through while they were captives there. One hour the Mounties got their man but paid a heavy price. One comrade had been forced to make the supreme sacrifice. Where are these men who would condemn the police force of our land? For opening mail and bugging rooms, they say it must be banned. Too bad these men were not on hand, I'm sure they'd say no more. If it were them who had to walk, come to that motel door.